Hi, we're here with Blake, one of the original kings of Houston's party scene. Blake, tell us a little bit about yourself, man.
So I started my journey in the industry 13 years ago at Cheesecake Factory in Dallas. Then I moved to Austin, was a door guy, a bar back, a manager, a bartender, and GM, all within like 2 years of moving out there.
Wow.
Yeah, lofty growth. And then I stuck out there for like 9 years. And moved with Handlebar out here to open this one. Loved it. Really came to my own there. Kind of found my, I guess, my bartending voice there, shirtless. And then I moved out to Nashville to open Dogwood with those guys. The world shut down. Now I'm back out here running Unicorn Disco.
Nice, man. Well, it's great having you out here. We love having you. With that being said, you've lived in three major Texas cities, Austin, Dallas, Houston. Now, you're really well known for bringing a really unique kind of trendy perspective to Houston. Did that past experience in Austin really sort of mold that taste profile to bring that to Houston?
Yeah, for sure, man. So I'll start off by saying this. I love what John and the guys and everyone's doing with Off the Menu, because it's the closest thing to the Austin family that I was used to in the service industry. You know, like whenever we... You weren't competing with the bars around you as much as you were being a friend and, you know, supportive to everyone who's in this family together. So it's really nice to see this kind of stuff. So my Austin take on it is that this is like the growth that Houston needed without sounding like I don't love Houston, right?
Got you.
Damn.
So what are some major differences between all the major Texas cities, Dallas, Austin, obviously Houston?
All right. So I would say Houston's barrier to entry into the party scene is the middle tier, because it's very definitive as where you're going. So like, if you want to go to a nightclub, you know you have heart. If you want to go to like a slutty bar, we'll call that Handlebar, you know. If you want to go to like a fun outgoing environment like this, a bar scene, you have FAO. In Austin, a lot of those things, like, you can brand yourself any direction, but people are going to make the space what they feel, and the Austin vibe kind of takes over a lot of those spaces. I would say Dallas is probably the most pretentious. I've never felt so unwelcome at a party in my entire life, but they throw great parties, you know, and everyone's very attractive, so.
Nice, man. Well, with that being said, you moved to Houston roughly 5 years ago, if I'm not mistaken. Mm-hmm. Now, this is during a time where there's a major transition in Austin's scene, and you sort of brought an interesting transition to Houston's scene. What do you think sparked these transitions within these cities?
Oh, man, so I'll speak for Austin for sure. Being the fastest growing city in America, you know, like, I mean, you have a lot of option. It's either pivot or don't get the couch up the staircase, you know? In Houston, I think it's a lot of, what do you call that? Like transients? Like, I know whenever I moved here with at least 20 people from Austin. And I think we kind of shook up the Houston landscape a little bit, you know? Because before that, I don't know anyone who was really, you know, taking their shirts off and, you know, spinning dildos around. Sorry, mom and dad. I don't know anyone's really doing that out here. So I think it's a lot of, we took some of our culture from the different places where we were and brought it to you guys, you know?
So do you think as someone coming into Houston, not necessarily a native, is it really important to keep those roots and to keep those influences from where you're from and bring them to Houston?
So I would say it's this. I would say be true to yourself. If that's the party that I think I'm thriving at, then I want to keep throwing that same party. There's something that I say, and I think it's pretty run around in the industry now. Every night you go to work, we're throwing our house parties.
Yeah.
So like, everyone needs to feel welcome. And I'll tell you right now, you're not coming to my house and we're not gonna drink wine and, you know, have caviar. It's gonna be Rumplemints and, you know, Twisted Teas. So I think just being true to yourself is like the biggest part.
So the question everyone wants to know, everyone knows you at least, why Rumplemints?
Man, I wish I had a better answer for it. So it started off, I was bartending on 6th Street. I was young, and we meet a lot of girls, drink a lot. You're yelling across a very loud bar. So I would originally would do the Rumplemints with some water and then spit it out. And then, 22-year-old, it's like, wait, why am I spitting this out? And I started drinking it. And then we started having all the fun in the world with Rumpleteenies and Rumpleteenies Dirty. And years of my life have been taken from Rumplemints. I happily forfeit them.
Let's hope not, man. We'd love to have you around as long as we can. With that being said, so Let's go back to the SpeedRailz competition. What do you think you bring to the table as a judge, and how do you think you help the competitors as well as help with the referee system?
Okay, so I'm excited to see what this looks like underneath the hood. I thought about competing last season. John asked me to come back as a judge this go-round. What do I bring to it? Hopefully fair eagle eyes, but yeah. No, I'm excited to see what it looks like from this side, so if I do choose to compete at a later date, you know, I got it all. Research the product.
We look forward to seeing you there, man. With that being said, man, you really do a great job of showing what hospitality can be and showing that hospitality can be a party. We appreciate that.
Yeah.
With that being said, man, thank you so much for having us.
Absolutely, man.
Is there anybody else you want to shout out for the camera?
Let's see here. I want to give a big shout out to Handlebar and Unicorn Disco, obviously. They birthed me, they raised me, I love them. I love you guys for everything. And I think we're out of the competition already, so best of luck to everybody who's involved.
There you have it.